This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we've derived the tangent of a sum of two angles. Now we're going to find the tangent of a difference of two angles. So we want to know, what's the tangent of A minus B? All right, so we don't know what that is, but we're going to start with what we do know. The tangent of A plus B, and in fact, I'm going to use different letters on purpose. How about we use C plus D? We know that formula is the tangent of C plus the tangent of D over 1 minus the tangent of C times the tangent of D. Now, of course, you can put any letters you want in here, right? X, Y, A, B, etc. I'm just using different ones so we don't confuse it with this first one. Now we want to somehow use that formula to do the tangent of A minus B. So here we go. We want to do the tangent of A minus B, but it's not in this form. So the question is, how can I rewrite this so it looks like the sum of two angles? Okay, well, actually I'll write over here. You could think of that as the tangent of A plus a negative b. And that's going to be very useful because now I could use this formula here. It's in this form, so it's the tangent of the first angle plus the tangent of the second angle. So what's that going to be? The tangent of the first angle is tangent of A plus the tangent of the second angle, which is the tangent of negative b, over 1 minus the tangent of the first angle times the tangent of the second angle. But we don't leave, that's not simplified. When you have a minus sign in the angle, you need to know what the tangent of negative b is, and the tangent is one of the odd functions. It's in previous videos. How do you get the tangent of negative b? It's the same thing as negative the tangent of b. When it's the sine or the tangent of a negative angle, it's the same as putting the minus outside. When it's a cosine, the cosine of negative b is exactly the same as the cosine of b. That's the even function. So this becomes tangent of A minus the tangent of B over 1. All right, now this minus sign here, okay, I'm going to pull it out, so it's going to be 1 minus, it's a little confusing, times a negative tangent of B. So these two negatives are multiplied. Make sure you think of this as just you're multiplying. That's just the coefficient of negative 1. It's not 1 minus tan A minus tan B. So finally, we get to tangent of A minus tangent of B all over 1 plus tangent of A tangent of B. So we started with this, and we ended with this right here. So now we have the formulas for the tangent of A plus B and the tangent of A minus B. Let's put those side by side. All right, so here are our two formulas, tangent of A plus B, tan A plus tan B over 1 minus tan A tan B, and tangent of A minus B is tan A minus tan B over 1 plus tan A tan B. So if in parentheses it's a plus, there's a plus in the numerator and minus in the denominator, and if there's a minus sign in the parentheses, there's a minus in the numerator and a plus in the denominator. And of course, if you forget the one for minus, you could do that little trick. Change this minus sign to plus and negative, and you fill it in. It just means you're going to do a few more steps along the way. All right, so on the next video, we will work some problems where we have to find the tangent of A minus B.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.